Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Tavia Sharp here, your go-to style and image consultant. And today I am having an interview with my friend Tom Principe. Hey Tom, how's it going?
Hi Tavia, good morning. I'm doing great. How about you?
Good, good. So Tom and I are going to be talking all about sales today. He's going to be giving you some awesome tips on how to really get better at your sales process in general, and kind of giving you some tools and tips on what you need to really think about how you're selling yourself. And so we're just going to dive right in. So, all right, first question, Tom. We talked about the difference between soft skills and hard skills. So why don't you tell me, what is the real difference between the two? And do you think they're equally as important in sales?
Yeah, so that's a great place to start, Tavia. So I have about 30 years of experience in sales and sales leadership. So I've kind of lived that life and I continue to do that as well. And I think what you just pointed out is critical because, you know, if you've grown up in sales, you know, then you've gone through a lot of training, a lot of development, but the majority of it will always focus on hard skills. So that's like, you know, your closing, probing questions, those kind of things. Today, I think what we're going to focus on is just as important, if not more so, and that's the soft skills. So that's like, how do you come across? How do people perceive you? What does your appearance suggest about you and your competence and your professionalism and your confidence? I think that's the skills that sometimes get overlooked that are really critically important, because you know the expression, you know, first impressions are lasting. And so you want to make that really good initial first impression, because before any words come out of your mouth, that's what people are going to be judging you on.
Absolutely. It's what, you know, you and I've always talked about is how are they responding to you? You know, when you show up to a Zoom meeting, a board meeting, just in general, when you're pitching yourself, even if they're just Googling you online, what do they find? You know, first it's that appearance part. And then once you're able to actually speak about yourself, what is going on? What are you communicating? Your body language, your eye contact, you know, it's all about what that other person is perceiving. And so it's often what we don't know that's actually maybe in the way. And that could lead to missed opportunities in sales, because people don't always say the not so nice things. We're right. Trained, you know, to say, be polite and say the nice things, but we don't know the not so nice things, but they're thinking it.
No, you're exactly right. And Tad, the other thing you hit on, which is really relevant for this time in our lives, is, you know, now you have another fact, you have Zoom, which is, you know, that's a whole nother component here. So if you're doing things in person and live, like the good old days, and hopefully we'll get back to those days, I think everyone knows, you know, you're going to get dressed, you're going to have your sport coat suit on, you might wear a tie, whatever. But Zoom is a whole different animal. And you've probably seen a lot of people on Zoom, their appearance, they're conveying in their appearance on Zoom is really not the most professional. And that's really important to think about as well.
Yeah, totally. I think I get a lot of questions and even some pushback on this when I talk about Zoom. But I just think of it as like, whatever you can use as a tool to really help you just be more confident and really sell yourself. Like when you have control over your image and how you dress and how you show up, that just gives you that power, and you can control how other people are perceiving you rather than just leaving it up to them. I mean, that's how I view it, and that's what I teach my clients. So
no, I think you're exactly right. So it is about establishing that control, you know, and you and I've talked before about the fact that the slightest change in appearance can be a huge boost to your ego and your confidence. You know, like I said, if I buy a new suit or a new shirt or even a new pair of socks, I put that on for whatever reason, it just changes my whole perception, attitude. I just feel like, wow, I look new. I look shiny. I look better. Yeah. And that exudes to your audience as well. They pick up on that.
100%. I think it's the energy, you know, that's what I always talk to people, because I get a lot of pushback sometimes. Like people want to say, oh, I don't like to wear a suit, or, you know, I'm not a suit guy. And I'm like, I'm not sitting here saying that you need to be a suit guy. You know, that's not necessary in all industries, right? Only specific industries. But I do feel that you can use your clothing to really boost your energy and raise that vibration, because that's what people respond to, is the energy. And when you can bring your energy to another level on a Zoom call, I mean, anything that we can use to do that is worth putting in the effort, in my opinion.
Yeah, no, exactly. Yeah. And Tavia, what you said is also important in terms of, you know, confidence. in sales in particular, right? I think whatever reason, people look at salespeople a little bit askew to begin with, right? There's always that skepticism. There's always that connotation of the used car salesman, so to speak. So what you said is really key, because what you're trying to do in your appearance is you want to exude confidence, but not cockiness, confidence, mm-hmm. and also credibility. And yeah. so how you look, how you appear is going to be important. And the other thing you also touched on was that you also want to dress based on your audience, right? So you want to try and pick the right styles that are going to match with the audience, the people you're going to be speaking to. And as you and I have talked about before, if I'm going to go into a boardroom, right, I'm going to pretty much be dressed to the nines, right? I'll have the suit, I'll have the tie, maybe some cufflinks, because you want to project a certain confidence and image to that group of people who are all very experienced executives. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, if I'm going to meet with a bunch of engineers and techs, and I might just wear the sport coat, no tie. I might just even take off my sport coat and roll up the sleeves, right?
Yeah.
So, but that's really important that you want to make sure that you dress according to your audience, because your audience, again, is going to be drawing those perceptions the minute you walk in the room.
Exactly. I love those points. Okay, so any experience that you can share, maybe it was somebody that you know that perhaps didn't put their best foot forward, and they should have, you know, when it really comes to closing yeah. the sale, you know, did they look the part and did it help them? Or, you know, if they didn't look the part, did it actually repel their potential customer?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think in my experience, at least, I also find it sometimes has to do with just age, right? And level of experience, right? Hopefully, as you progress in your career and you've maybe been fortunate to work with people like yourself, you understand the importance, right, of your appearance. I remember I worked when I was in a marketing director role, I worked with a young product manager, great guy, very bright, very smart guy, but young, right? Mm-hmm. And he would, when he dressed, I always remember this, I don't know why, but you would always see his undershirt, you know, he'd have the button unbuttoned, you see the undershirt, okay? And that became kind of a pet peeve of mine, because what his appearance was suggesting was that he was kind of a college kid, oh, right? And so yep. when he's trying to present now in front of, you know, product people, or even the executive team, if he had to do a presentation with the executive team, his appearance now is conveying that, he's kind of a kid. And why are we listening to him? He doesn't even look, he looks like a college student the way he's dressed in his open shirt and the undershirt showing those kind of things. And just that little bit of tweaking to kind of make him aware that, you know, Bill, if you're going into the boardroom, you kind of want to look the part, not that you have to be in a three-piece suit, but you want to at least polish up some of the rough edges. And I think that was a big learning experience for him. But again, Tavi, you know from your work, a lot of people just don't even take the time to keep talk with people about those things. That's why I think what you're doing is so important, because people aren't even thinking about it.
Yeah, you just hit that, right? People aren't thinking about it until they get the feedback. And that just happened to one of my clients who came to me because he got feedback that he didn't get the job that he wanted was because they didn't take him seriously. They didn't think that he was a viable candidate. You know, and he happens to be a very good executive coach. But what happened was they went to his website, saw his appearance, and he didn't look the part of somebody that they thought, you know, would really bring that, you know, that credibility, that experience to the table for the job. So he didn't get the job. And that was why he came to me. So he said, I don't want that to keep happening. But yeah. unless you get the feedback, you know, it's almost like you have to take it upon yourself to know, like, hey, maybe I could be doing something better. And one thing you could be doing better, because we don't have control of a lot of things right now, but we have control of how we show up every day.
Exactly.
So if
exactly.
that's something that could help you, then why would you not do it? That's, I guess, my thought. So.
Well, and also what you said is so important, Tavi. It's what we were saying at the beginning of the conversation, is that before you even step into the room, somebody's already drawn an impression of what you should look like, right? So
yeah.
if you're a coach, you should look, if you're a head of sales, you should look this way. Mm-hmm. And if you don't kind of at least meet that image, that right. perception for the part,
yes.
to your point, everything's going to blow up just like it did with this gentleman.
Yeah, totally. Okay, so what advice would you give someone looking to sell with more confidence and credibility and just really improve their sales process overall?
Yeah. So aside from obviously, you know, learning the hard skills, which are a whole, you know, process in and of itself, the developmental piece, mm-hmm. but that's the part that a lot of programs already focus on. I think based on our conversation today, the important things are, you know, if you look good, you feel good. And that confidence is so important in how you carry yourself, particularly in sales, because people are trusting you, they're buying into you. And so if you can convey that image that, hey, I know what I'm talking about, I'm comfortable with myself, I'm confident, again, not cocky, but confident, mm-hmm. I think that's gonna come across in your appearance and how you look. And like I said, as soon as you walk in that room, all eyes are on you. And so you're not gonna get a second chance to make that first impression. So you wanna make sure that you're, you know, that you look the part of what you were trying to be.
Absolutely. I think of it in this way, you know, some people are just naturally confident people. They mm-hmm. they have a natural charisma and confidence. But then there's the people that it doesn't really come natural, right? Or maybe it takes a lot to get yourself in that mindset, you know, that, yeah. hey, I'm going to close these deals, this deal today, right? So my thought is like, you know, put on your power, you know, put on that power that makes you feel empowered to yep. just give you that extra leg up, you know, to help you boost that confidence so that you can actually show up where your just energy is high and you're able to close like that much easier. So, you know, that's really what I teach. And I think Tom agrees with my.
Well, it's amazing, Tavi, how your appearance contributes to that. And, you know, a great analogy just came to mind. Think about Clark Kent and Superman, right?
Yeah.
Two different images,
yeah.
right? But when he changes into Superman, totally different person, right?
Totally
the man of steel.
Person.
It's the same. Yeah, so it's the same thing here. You wanna look and feel your best because mentally that's what's going to help you be successful.
Absolutely. Well, that's a great place to end it. You know, I appreciate your time today. And where can they find you, Tom, if people want to get in touch with you?
So you can go to my website. It's Sales Success. So it's https://sales.com. And you'll find my website there. And I welcome anybody to come and check me out.
All right. I'll put it in the link here too. So people can just click on it when they watch this video and get in touch with you. Thanks again for being with me here today. And I hope everybody learned some awesome sales tips and really how to, you know, just give yourself some leverage. You know, sure. if you're not using your image the way you should be, just why not, you know, put a little bit more effort, even if it's from here up, since people are just seeing us in the
exactly,
frame,
in the Zoom.
You know, take these tips and roll with it and watch yourself really improve in your sales process. So yeah.
Thanks, Gabby. I enjoyed chatting with you.